Thank you, first of all, for taking time and to be with us tonight. And also thank you for making such an exquisite and thoughtful film. Really appreciate it.
谢谢你们抽时间来加入我们，也谢谢你们制作一个这么精巧和深思熟虑的片子。So
I want to start tonight's conversation by asking you a question about your trilogy.
我想先问你一个关于这个三部曲的一个问题。
So from 2012 to 2022, you worked on the trilogy, the first one being Egg and Stone, the second one, The Foolish Bird, and then the third one, of course, is Stonewalling. So this project took 10 years. And I just wanted to know, when you first decided to pursue this project, what was your original vision, your original goal, and what did you hope to explore? And has the project evolved over time?
我从2012年到2022年，从第一部《鸡蛋与石头》，第二部《笨鸟》，第三部《石门》，这过去10年里面，有什么这个项目有什么样的发展变化，还有你们。
最开始，开始这个三部曲的时候，原来的想法是什么样子的？你们想达到了一些什么样的目的？你说吧。Hello，大家好，我是黄记。
Hi everyone, I'm
鸡蛋和石头呢，是跟我自己的这个小的时候在农村生活的这个被性骚扰的这个经历有关系。For
the film Egg and Stone, it's derived from my own experience growing up in rural countryside and my own experience of being sexually assaulted.
那笨鸟呢，是跟我高中的时候，第一次跟男朋友的不愉快的这个性体验有关系。And
the second film, Foolish Bird, is originated from my first unhappy sexual experience with my boyfriend at the time in high school.
这三部电影呢，都是同一个女孩子演的。They
were all played, the leading role in all three films were played by the same actress.
然后拍完了第一部和第二部以后，我们的这个演员姚红贵呢，她去大的城市读大学。
After the first and the second film, our actress Hong Gui, she set off to a big city for college.
所以呢，我们按照她和其他的在城市里面生活的女大学生的这个经历呢，拍了第三部。
And so our third film is based according to her and other female college students' experience in an urban setting.
所以你说。对，其实那个鸡蛋和石头是已经10年之前的片子，然后呢，当时是最近在日本也是比较有很多新闻关于这个性骚扰的这个问题。 当时那个时候呢，是在中国也是，但是还隐瞒，没有在报道上很少出现。Now
that we look back, Egg and Stone was made in 10 years ago. At nowadays we can hear a lot of media reports about sexual abuse or sexual violence in Japan, but 10 years ago in China and Japan, there were very few discussions about the subject.
但是呢，那个放了鸡蛋和石头了以后，很多的女性的观众，他们给我们分享了他们的这种，不能讲出来的这个自己的体验。
After making egg and stone, a lot of female audiences start sharing their unspeakable experiences with us.
对，所以从那个时候，我们开始，那这个每一个女性的年龄段，又到了那个性问题是在哪里，然后呢，会影响到什么东，什么事情，伤害到什么，对，所以呢，我们是通过一个女孩子，这个演员，一个女孩子的成长的过程，去表达这个女性的一个这些对性的问题吧。
Since then, we wanted to stay closely with the sexual experiences with that every woman can relate it to, and we followed the growth of this teenage girl and looked at what kind of influences she had received.
Okay. Great, thank you. So I'm going to move on to the next question. So I understand stonewalling took you the longest to complete because you put aside 10 months on the shooting alone. So I wanted to know, what is the thinking behind this? Why 10 months? And over this shooting process, did you encounter any surprises? Anything that you didn't expect? Thank you.
所以我就下一个问题啊，就是我知道十门是你们拍摄时长最长的一个片子，它用了10个月。我就想问一下，你们在开始这个拍摄之前的一些想法是什么？然后为什么会花了10个月的时间呢？然后在这10个月的时间里面，你们经历了哪些意外的事情？
因为我们从一开始的时候就想，按照一个女性怀孕10个月，然后在怀孕10个月的这个时间里面，她在她的不同的这个阶段，孕期在不同的这个怀孕的这个阶段，会带会对她的生理、心理还有她的生活呢带来什么样的影响？ 想从这样的角度去表现这个女孩。
So from the very beginning, we knew that we want to follow the 10-month duration of a woman's pregnancy and follow closely with the different stages of her pregnancy and look at what kind of influences that she have gone through in terms of physiologically, psychologically, and what kind of changes she will experience in life.
但是呢，这个演员是不是真的怀孕了？她是表演这个怀孕这个词。
But our actress is not really pregnant. She's just playing the role of pregnant woman.
所以呢，我们决定。 那怎么让她体验这个怀孕的这个时间这个10个月？对，因为她的身体是不可以体验的，所以呢，我们安排在这个10个月里面。然后呢，当然是她没有怀孕，但是她通过演戏，她一直意识自己是在怀孕。
Therefore, we wanted our actress to experience the full duration of the pregnancy, even though her body is not really experiencing all the changes. But we from the beginning, pressured, wanted her to pretend that she's in such a state.
然后呢，我们这次先说那个，对，然后我们是这个10个月的过程当中。 想拍下来那个这个中国的当时社会的变化，对，所以那个疫情最后发生的疫情也是，根据那个我们拍摄的这个事件里面，真的是发生了这个情况，然后我们根据那个情况去改了这个故事。
And within this 10 month, we also would like to record the social changes in China. For instance, the happen of pandemic, it's something that we didn't expect, and we have changed the screenplay accordingly.
这个是比较最大的意外的事情,
That's the biggest surprise.
Okay, thank you for the answer. So I'm glad that you clarified about Yang Honggui, the actress, not being pregnant for real, because I actually had questions, people asking me, did she really get pregnant? So I think you guys did a wonderful job of directing her.
我谢谢你澄清这个，很多人问我红贵是不是真的怀孕了，因为她看起来真的很像一个怀孕的女孩。
So my next question is about the mother and daughter relationship, this being a film very much from a woman's perspective. So my question is, do you, from your perspective, both as individuals and as filmmakers, do you feel that the burden of being a daughter from a more regional family background it tends to be a little heavier than, say, that for women coming more from an urban background? Because in the film, we see Lin ends up being the one helping her mother pay back the mother's debt.
我下一个问题有关母女关系，因为这个片子是从一个女性视角来展开的。我想问一下你，作为你个人，也作为一个导演，你来看，你觉得一个身为一个农村的女儿或身负的重担会比城市的女儿更重吗？因为在像这个片子里面，红贵需要为她的母亲去还债。
先说是你的妈妈，你们两个人。就是因为这个电影里面的这个那个演妈妈的那个角色真的是我的妈妈，然后那个爸爸也真的是我的爸爸。In
the film, the woman who plays the mother of Hong Gui is my real mom, and same as her dad, who is my father.
在那个前面的鸡蛋和石头还有笨鸟里面的时候，我的爸爸和妈妈在那个两个片子里面基本上是缺席的，就是不存在的。
In my previous two films, Egg and Stone and Foolish Birds, my parents were absent in the films.
因为他们就是在我很小的时候，他们就去 广东那边打工，就是改革开放嘛，他们就去广东那边工作。
It was deliberately so, because as the experience as a leftover child in rural area, my parents were both migrant workers who left our village to work in coastal cities.
那在拍石门的时候，我是第一次 这么长时间跟他们生活在一起。
The making of Stonewalling is for the first time I'm living with them for such a long time.
所以呢，红贵和爸爸妈妈之间的电影里面的女孩和她爸爸妈妈之间的这个感情的距离的关系，其实也是我 在生活，我们在拍摄的同时，我和我的爸爸妈妈之间的感情的距离关系。So
the emotional distance that Hong Gui in the film experiencing with her parents is something resonates in real life. The kind of emotional distance I was experiencing with my own parents.
所以不知道是，虽然是父母和孩子的关系，但是不知道是从什么角度要去建立这个关系。
Even though the film is about the parent-child relationship, but I didn't know how to establish this relation from what kind of background.
是感情的，很纯粹的感情的角度，还是经济上帮忙的角度？
whether from a pure emotional perspective or from a more kind of economic perspective.
嗯嗯，对，所以我想就是在城市里面的女孩，有可能也会有像我或者是片子里面的林森这样子的跟父母之间的关系也会有。
I think for daughters growing up in the urban setting, I think they might also have the similar experience, the kind of distancing with parents like me.
例如一个有钱的家庭，如果他突然破产了，他的孩子啊，是不是要去想办法帮助爸爸妈妈去还钱？
Imagine a daughter from a wealthy family. If the parents goes bankrupt, the daughter might have to help with the financial situation as well.
对，最近很多的在美国上学的留学生，他的爸爸妈妈在中国的生意可能是突然之间破产了，然后这个留学生他要怎么去跟他的爸爸妈妈建立这个新的关系？这种事情好像现在也很多。
For instance, I've heard about like international student, Chinese international student in the US. They have gone through a lot of changes. Like their parent. It's gone. It's on. Sorry. Like their parents have business suffered a great deal during the pandemic. These international students have to re-establish their relation with parents at home.
总之，中国就是在一个快速变化的一个，中国的变化就是太快了，总是会有任何的事情都是跟经济和赚钱有关系。
In all, changes happen so fast in China, and you can expect any kind of change that might have something to do with the economic situation.
对，嗯，对。
So speaking of changes, I'm gonna ask you my last question before I open up the floor about China's transformations, because you dedicated 10 years. On this trilogy, on your project, and you call it an extended observation about the changes in China. So from your perspective, again, both as individuals and as directors, what do you see to be the biggest, some of the biggest transformations of China?
现在提到中国的变化，现在我想问你们最后一个问题，然后之后我们就把这个提问交给观众。 在你们过去10年的这个拍摄的过程中，你们说这三部片子是一个长时期的对中国的一个观察。那对你们个人和对你们作为导演来说，你觉得中国经历的最大的一个变化是什么呢？哦，我觉得就是过去的10年对我来讲，就是最大的一个变化就是中国的这个城镇化建设。
For me, in the past 10 years, I think the biggest change happening in China is urbanization.
就是要建造这个城市，然后再建造这个镇。镇。
镇就是township, also township, not just big cities, but also the development constructions of the... Right, the third, four-tier cities, townships.
所以大量的农村的人去到大的城市，然后呢，去作为劳动力就补充到大的城市的建造里面。Enormous
amount of people have to migrate from rural area to cities participate in this development.
但是当这个建造完成的时候，他们又要。 又要被迫的，又要再就是又要回到这个农村。
But the urbanization process is finished, all these migrant workers have to go back to the villages again.
在这个过程里面，被留下来的首先肯定是小孩和女性呢，和小孩和女性，对。
And in this process, the first group of people who left in the who were left in the village, of course, are children and women.
所以我们的这个那在这个留下来的这个小孩和未成年的女性里面就会发生大量的这个被受到伤害的事情。
So a lot of harm happens among this group, among the teenagers and women.
一切的最后的最末端的承受者就是女性嘛。
I think the victims of all this transformation in the as the bottom of society, they are always women.
那我们过去的这个三部片子，在过去的这个十年，其实就是从讲了一个从村到被留下来的，被留在村里的一个小女孩，然后呢，她从村到镇，然后呢，她最后到了城市，然后呢，在城市还是她没有办法找到自己的一个立足之地的这样的一个故事，就是一个十年吧。
In this 10 years and 3 films, we have outlined a long journey of a girl, a leftover rural girl, who moved to a small town and further into a big city, and still not being able to find her own position in the society.
但是我觉得大种可能他有他的角度的一个看法。
I think Ryuji might have his own observations.
如果从比较宽的这个社会问题的角度去看这个十年的话，我觉得是这个人口的问题都看到了在那个十年里面。From
the broadest angle and looking at the social change, I think the biggest change is related to the issue of population.
因为还是目前现在在讨论对自然的环境的影响或者经济市场，都是这些问题是都是跟人口也有关系。I
think the heated discussion about nature, about economy, they are all related to population.
然后这个十年里面，中国决定把这个独子什么那个一个人是孩子啊，就是那个。
独生子女政策，对，独生子女政策，对，他们结束了，对吧？结束了。这个我觉得是，然后呢，他把希望把人口更多了，对不对？对。但是这个方向和全世界的想把这个人口要涨上，因为会影响到一些这个。 影响到那个自然环境啊什么的，对吧？所以呢，这个矛盾是我觉得有点存在。哦，他的意思就是说，我翻译一下，他的意思就是说，这个中国是把这个以前的这个独生子女政策，就现在就变成了多胎子女政策，就鼓励大家就是要多生嘛，但是他的这个政策。 现在的这个政策，它其实是跟当下全球的，要对那个环保啊，然后资源的这个，是因为是有人口的问题了。对对对，这个是其实是又有点相反的，
相反的
一个走向。嗯，对。
I think the past 10 years, China have changed its one-child policy into multiple children policy to encourage people to give birth to more children in one household in hope of increasing its population. But this trend, I think it goes in the opposite direction with the rest of the world when we are more often emphasizing the problems of the environment and sustainable resources.
对，所以比较这个十年里面，这个点是或怎么会影响到未来是比较感兴趣。对。And
I'm very interested in how these policy changes in China will influence the future.
所以在石门里面，那个代孕的这个市场在中国它是灰色地带啊，但是它一直都在民间都是存在着。
In Stonewall, you see the scene of the surrogate business is it's in the gray area of the society, but it has always existed.
所以因为以前中国的这个独生子女政策，所以有很多的人他没有孩子，或者他只有一个孩子，但是那个孩子后来也没有了，所以他们需要再通过其他的这个方法。 然后再去得到一个孩子。
During the one-child policy era, if a family has no children or loses the single child, they have to look for some underground channels to get another child.
Thank you. 市长好, how much time do we have? 10 minutes? Yeah. 10 minutes, okay. So, thank you for your patience. We have time, 10 minutes, to have those of you in the audience to ask questions. So if you're interested, please raise your hand. And?
I'm curious about the cross-cultural aspect of screenwriting and directing, you know, the Japanese tradition and Chinese. What issues arose?
这位观众他感兴趣，你们两个在写剧本和拍摄过程中的一些跨文化的合作，就里面会发生什么，就是有什么意识，有什么问题出现呢？你们怎么解决的呢？好的，对，从日本和中国的传统出发。
可能我首先不是很想谈中国和日本的跨文化的合作，而是男性和女性的合作。
I want to emphasize it's more about women and men's cross-gender collaboration rather than China-Japan's cross-cultural collaboration.
因为待会你讲哈，因为我还是我是一个女性吧，所以现在讲的又是女性的故事，所以呢，我非常的想。 去呈现，他们有那个有力量的那个部分。
As a woman, I always wanted to tell the stories of women, and I wanted very much to present the story of women with strong agency, with power.
有时候这个意愿太过于强烈，甚至会有美化的感觉。
Sometimes this desire is too strong that I cross over into idealizing women.
但是这个时候呢，是因为有这个，因为六级他会跟我讨论，然后他会从一个另外的一个角度呢，去看这个女性比较相对客观的去看待这个女性在。 这个当下的这个时空里面，他的位置吧，嗯。
And during these moments, Ryuji will intervene and provide some more objective perspective and in the specific temporality of the story.
这个当然也跟我们自己的表达有关系，因为我们还是想。 去讲中国当下正在发生的故事。
And it relates, it has more to do with what's happening in China, what's happening now.
从这个中国和日本的关系的话，我其实会关注这个经济发展的这个时代。因为从 这个角度来说，日本比中国早大概二十年，已经经济发展了。
For me, my interest related to Sino-Japanese relationship has always to do with the levels of economic development. Japan, I think, has become a developed country roughly 20 years earlier than China.
然后我自己体验过80年代的日本的泡沫经济，然后2000年的中国的泡沫经济。
I myself have experienced both the bubble economy in Japan in the 1980s and China's bubble economy in the 2000s.
所以我觉得是这个历史是我自己认为一个循环，所以呢，我看中国的时候也是可以看到日本的过去隐瞒的东西是什么。
So I for me it's a repeating of the history, and by observing what China is going on now, I can see what was hidden in the history of Japan.
对，这个是我看那个中国和日本两边的时候一直在想的事情，然后在电影里面也是想通过表现的这个怎么把当代社会。 表现对这个，怎么在中国的当代社会里面表现出来的？对。<laughs>
And these are has always been my interest, my thoughts, and the aspect that I wanted to reveal in my filmmaking.
Great. Well, thank you so much. So we have time for one more question. We have a hand over there in the front.
Hi, thank you so much for the beautiful film. I was curious if you could give a little bit of background around the title of your film, Stonewalling, and love your thoughts behind that. And I would also really love to know what happened to the baby of yours, and what your intention was, or if you meant to leave the reviewer hanging, because it was such a, as a mother myself of two children, it was so painful to watch that last scene.
You can see her body reacting to that child's cry. But anyway, there was just so many things. But I love your thoughts on what happened at the end, too. 我想问的问题是关于这个题目石门，它有代表什么样的意思呢？还有一个就是关于它的结尾，它是一个两个孩子的母亲，所以看到最后这一个。
这一幕，他主角的身体因为听到婴儿哭声而感到疼痛，让他自己也觉得很疼痛，但是他还是很感谢你们，制作一个这么美的电影。是吗？那师门的意思，还是我自己会觉得女性在生活里面，就是她有很多看不见的这个阻碍。
The title related to what I think in women's life, there's lots of invisible obstacles.
这个阻碍有的时候就是像那个石头一样，就是特别厚、特别重，怎么推也推不开。And
these obstacles reminds me of like thick stone walls. That it's almost impossible to push away.
就是这样的意思，就是这样的意思。对，还有那个结尾。还有对结尾的话，就是，对，因为这个是我自己的一个来自于我自己生了孩子以后母乳喂养，的一个亲身的一个经验和体验。
And the ending has to do with my own experience of giving birth to a child and the pain of breastfeeding.
就是我听到别的孩子哭的时候，我的乳房也会很有反应，也会很痛。Sometimes
when I hear the cries of other babies, my breasts will react and feel pain as well.
所以我想，通过女性的这个。 生理反应，去通过女性的这个生理的疼痛呢，去讲她的这个已经发生的这个事情，在她身上留下的这个痕迹。
So I wanted to talk about the traces this incident has left in Lynn's life through her physical. Reaction, her physical pain.
对你呢？你的感想呢？
结尾。对。就一没事。
对，我已经讲了。反正一切都会留下痕迹吧。
The ending, the undecided ending will leave a trace on audiences as well, I hope.
以前是文字, 现在是影像。
文字?
就文字, 文学啊, 文章, 画, 绘画。
Literature, scripts, whatever.
以前在历史。 在历史里面，他也记得是那个文字记录和绘画记录，对吧？
Okay, so in the past, historical traces were left through writing, and now we want to leave traces in history through filmmaking.
对，现在是通过影像、电影啊，每个老普通的人自己拍的这个影像，都把历史留下了，把历史的痕迹留下来。
And now through everyone, through the accessibility of image making technology, I think everyone has the opportunity to leave their own trace in history.
中国的过去的十年已经过去了，但是我希望我们拍的电影是留下了这个过去的十年里面的一个痕迹。
The last decade has passed, and but we hope to have kept some keep a record of this 10 year.
对。
Well, I think that's all the time we have for tonight. I want to thank you, Director Huang and Director Oscar. Thank you so much for taking time from your busy schedule to be with us tonight. And I'm really thankful that you are doing an important job being a historian and through images. And this is really wonderful. Thank you again.
Thank you.
I just also want to, on behalf of China Institute, thank both directors for making such amazing, beautiful, neat movies, films that were doing a lot for China and for the world. Thank you very much. And also thanks to Karen for moderating today's program. Thanks to my colleague Kenshi and Kevin here, making the program possible. And also, of course, for coming tonight. Thank you very much.
And thank you to Zoe.
China Institute 负责人说想代表这个机构谢谢你们。 不用跟他们发吗？对，还有谢谢 Karen 对。
So this is the first program for the fall, and
next
year, oh, yeah. You're back. Oh, this one.
Nice.